Hi, this is Shakir Ahmed. Welcome to the SPSS learning tutorial. In today's tutorial, we learn how to perform reliability testing in SPSS. Before going to SPSS analysis, we first learn what is reliability testing. Reliability is basically testing of instrument to check whether the instrument would give the same result if the instrument were to be taken again under the same condition. For example, if we are checking the weight of certain person again and again, the weight is different for different time point, then we say that the instrument which is measuring the weight of the person is invalid or unreliable. Basically, validity is related to the accuracy, while reliability is related to the precision. Precision means a reliable answer or a reliable response is need not to be exact with the actual answer, but for repeated measurement or repeated on repeated occasion, the answer should be same. Like if a person's height is measured, or if we ask income of a person many time, if he or she answer the same option or same answer on different times, then we say that the answer is reliable. So reliability is basically connected with consistency. If now in statistical surveys or studies, we test whether our questionnaire or the questions in a questionnaire are consistent to each other, or the responses of a person or of a respondent is consistent from the one question to the next question. If the questions are asked on same construct or same idea, so there are three basic types of reliability testing. One is test retest reliability. In this type of reliability, we test the responses of a group of people from one time to the other time. Means we take responses two times and the correlation between the responses are checked and used as a reliability measure. If there is a high correlation between the responses on two occasions, then we said that the questionnaire is reliable. And split half reliability, we divide this survey into two halves. For example, we can separate or divide the odd number questions and even number questions and calculate the correlation of the score on the scale from the two halves. So reliability is in such cases, reliability is a function of the number of questions in the scale and the extent to which how effectively halved the number of questions. We just split the questions or the number of questions into two halves and then check the correlation between the two halves. If there is a high correlation, we said that the questionnaire is or the questions are reliable. Otherwise, we said that the question is not reliable or the questions are not reliable. So the third and the most used reliability testing is internal consistency, which is used for the data on Likert scale. So for such type of internal consistency, we should do the questions on a unidirectional scale are there should be a unidirectionality in questions. For example, if we asking a question and the answer or the options are on a strongly disagree to or strongly agree scale, and the next question is strongly agree to strongly disagree scale. So the direction of the two questions are not same. So this is not unidirectionality. So your question should be, or your questions should be on a same direction, meaning that all the questions have options from 1 to 5 or 5 to 1 at same time. And the unidimensionality means the scale of measurement for all variables should be same. For example, if two questions are on nominal scale and the three questions are on ordinal scale, then we can not perform the reliability of dead questions using internal consistency. So the Kronborg alpha is basically used to measure the internal consistency or reliability of a questionnaire. It possesses values between 0 and 1, 0 meaning that the questions the questionnaire is not reliable at all, and 1 meaning that the questionnaire is absolutely reliable. A value of greater than 0.7 is usually preferred as the appropriate or reliable question. So we start, or we apply the Kronborg alpha method for testing the reliability of a questionnaire. We again take our basic example of educational assessment, and we are asking different questions to the students: age of student, gender of student, student score in subject A. But these all questions are not on same scale, we can't perform the Kronborg alpha method on all questions at same time. For unidimensionality and unidirectionality, we need questions on same scale and in same direction. We have question 1 to 5 on same scale, all on ordinal scale. I will change this scale of variable on ordinal, and the variables and the scales are also same. You can just copy and then paste on the to make all the options same. So all the variables, all the questions, all the five questions have same dimension and same direction, 1 to 5, and the scale of measurement for all five variables is ordinal. So we continue for testing the reliability for these five questions. Go to the option of scale and then reliability analysis, and send the items to the reliability in an item box. The grade of student is not on such scale or not on for the same extract. Although the grade of student is also on same scale and same measurement, but the directionality or the responses are the grade of student belongs to the another extract or another idea. These five questions are representing the same idea or same extract. These are all related to the COVID-19 precautionary measure. So first question is that your institution ensures follow-up of COVID-19, and face mask is an effective personal protective equipment, and we should avoid going to public gathering, and social distancing is the only way to stop the spread of COVID-19, and hand washing is also effective in COVID-19 prevention. So you need to select alpha. From this list, I already chosen alpha as this. You can give a scale label for checking this extract COVID-19 prevention. And then go to the statistics, and you can give descriptives for items, and then scale if item is deleted, and intra item correlations, and you can also find mean and variances, but for now I let these summaries for the time being. And you can continue, and then okay. So this is your case processing summary. All the 20 values are valid, no values are excluded or missing, and the Cronbach alpha value is very small, which is 0.183. And this is your item statistic. For this is mean for item 1, and this is mean for item 2, and this is mean for item 3, and these are the standard deviations, and these are the number of values. And inter item correlation matrix measures the correlation or the responses of the between the items. This is the correlation between the UN institution ensures follow-up of COVID-19 SOPs, and the face mask is an effective PPE for COVID-19 prevention. There should be a high correlation between the responses for each question. If any question provide negative values, then it shows that the response for the this question is quite different, are going in different direction to the response for this question. So we need to exclude one variable or one question from our extract or from our group of questions. Item total statistic. These are the Cronbach alpha we obtain if we exclude this variable, if we delete this item. If we delete your institution ensures follow-up of COVID-19 SOPs, then we will get a Cronbach alpha of 0.36, a little higher than the existing one. If we exclude this variable, then we obtain a smaller Cronbach alpha, and so on. So I would like to delete first item and then recompute the result. Go to reliability analysis and exclude the first variable, and then click on OK. Now your Cronbach alpha is improved, and this is now 0.361. If we exclude the face mask is an effective PPE for COVID-19, then we will obtain a Cronbach alpha of 0.658, which is almost near to 0.7, and we consider as a reliable questionnaire. So we now exclude our next variable, face mask, and then continue. Now you will see a higher 0.7. You will see a 0.658 Cronbach alpha value, which is somehow acceptable. If you want to exclude this variable again, then you will find a Cronbach alpha of 0.712. So as much as you delete the variables, you will get a higher Cronbach alpha. So these are all about the reliability analysis of items in a questionnaire. थैंक यू, सब्सक्राइब द चैनल फॉर मोर वीडियोस रिलेटेड टू सच टॉपिक्स ऑफ रिसर्च एंड स्टैटिस्टिक. थैंक यू.